Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss the topics of ARA method, how we can communicate between different components, how we can define the method in a component and invoking that method from the different component. That's we can see in ARA method. For that we used events. Till now we can use this also, and ARA if, how we can render the part of a component based on conditional logic, and how we can include external CSS libraries and external JavaScript libraries. Okay, then we can discuss with lightning required. Let's see everything practically. Let's discuss about ARA method first. Okay, now for that I'm going to create a component. So I already have this account controller CLS which gives account records. Now I'm going to create a component. See here, I'm going to create a component. Component method. And here to include our controller, you just need to use controller attribute. Then now you have to define a method like this, and you can change name here, retrieve accounts, then, and you can define a method, you can define a function through an attribute. Whenever you have a server side controller invocation, then you need a callback function to send that response back to the component which is invoking this component. If you don't have such type of calls, server side component, you don't need to have callback function. Okay, let it be. Now I'm giving the method name here, same method name, and then, so you know how to do that, right? So I'm getting accounts, so now here what you can get, you can get the records by using get return value. And then how can you pass this records to another component which is invoking this component method? So first of all, you have to take the arguments. Like this. So this event.getParams arguments can get all the values assigned to this parameters. Okay, and then you can define a callback function. Let's put ACT callback. Then can include these records to, you can pass that records to this method. Okay, now it is ready to give the records which is written from the method to another component if it invokes this method from that component. Okay, for that what we have to do, let's create another component. So method caller, then here you don't need to pass the controller here. Okay, first thing is like this, just defined an attribute and you added one title, account records, and now you are invoking, you are including component. Okay, which component it is? Component method is the component, and I gave ID. Through this, I can call the method involved in the component method. Okay, let's see. So let's prepare iteration also here. So now with this iteration, you are just going through the account records and you are displaying the name. That's all. And now I'm giving one lightning button here. That. Right? And I'll make it as click me. Now, in this method, I'm going to write a logic how to invoke the method of lightning component. Okay, it's a simple thing, just need to follow the things. First thing is, you have to find out the component by using ID you given here, and then you just need to invoke the method. What is our method name? What's the method name? Retrieve accounts. Just put it here. Done. Okay. So how it gives the results? Whenever it calls this method, and this method contains this logic. Okay. And once it gets the account records, then it is passing that records to the action callback. Account callback function, then it can give this result here through this function of result. Okay, so this result will be here. Let's see, let's include this in an application to see the result. So it's demo 6. C colon component method caller. Let's see how it looks like. Response is not defined. Really? Component method controller. Spelling mistakes, nothing else. Yes, see, you got the records. What we did, we defined a method in a component, and we are utilizing or we are invoking that method and getting the result into the component. And if you observe in the method caller, component method caller, I am not including any controller, any Apex class by using controller attribute. So what is the main advantage of this? First of all, not only invoking the methods from the component, you can have or you can define different components with different controllers. That means basically there is a limitation. In component you can include only one Apex class, but if you want to work with the multiple Apex classes at a time from the same component, you can have reusable components with the method definitions, with the controllers. Okay, and then you can have all, you can include those components here, and you can invoke that methods. That means indirectly you are including multiple Apex controllers in the component because of this ARA method. Okay, now with this we have completed how we can define the a method in a component by using ARA method. Okay, and how we can pass the result through callback function. Okay, now what I am going to do, I will define one more attribute name equals object name, type equals string, default value equals account. Now I'm going to call this method. Here we have get accounts now. Now I'm going to call this method which can take the object name. So just to give you info, where is that? Let's put name only here to make this, otherwise let it be. And you can have fields also, string fields. Now I'm making this method dynamic. Can have this now. Now where is our method? Component method. This is account for now by default, and I want to pass field names also. With the comma separation. Now let's see, I'm going to change this get accounts to get account records. Where is that? This one. And we have to pass this parameters to this. How we can pass? Where we can get that parameters? Through this attributes only we can get, right? Because we defined a method retrieve accounts. In that we have defined methods, we have defined attributes, those are all arguments for this method. Then we can pass these arguments from any component which is invoking this component method. Now what are the things, what are the arguments we have? Object name and field name. Let's see. First thing is we have to put action set params, and then you have to follow JSON format, as you know that. And what is the object name? Is the parameter name of Apex controller method. And what is the value? Here you can get the all arguments params dot. Okay, what's the argument name? Object name, comma. And what is the another parameter for Apex control method? Fields colon params dot. So you always do copy paste here only, don't try to type. Okay, because JavaScript is case sensitive, whatever you define you just copy and paste here. So with this, what you are doing, you are passing the parameters through Apex controller method, okay, by using attributes or arguments you defined in the ARA method. Okay, and then you have to pass these values from a component where you are invoking this method, invoking this retrieving method. Let's see. And one more thing, you have to follow the order also. Here function is the first order. Okay, that's what you are doing right away, right now. And second, object name. Third, field name. That in that way only you have to pass, otherwise it won't work. Okay, let's go go with component method controller. Okay. Now you made it as a reusable method. Here, see here, component result. This is one for this retrieve account. This is one attribute. Okay, that's a callback function. Now you have to give one more attribute, contact. Okay, and fields you can give with comma separation. For now, I am giving name. Okay, let's see. See, you got contact records. Okay, what I am doing? I am passing these values while calling this method. Right? So this is how we can pass the parameters, pass the arguments from the parent component. If you observe, this is one parameter up to this, and another one is object name, another one is field names. Done. Now with this, we got to know how to define the method in the component level and how to include the how to invoke that method from the parent component, and how to pass the arguments, and what is the purpose also. Now we know, right? Now if you observe this, even we don't have account records, it is giving account records label and click me button, right? Click me is should be there. Whenever we click on click me only, we can get the records. But account records, I don't want to see. I want to see that message, please click on click me to retrieve the records. This is the message I want to show. If there is no accounts, if there is accounts, I want to hide that message. So I am going to do that by using RAF. Let's do that. Okay, so we don't need to worry about it. I am in Lightning library. Now how to use that Lightning library? See here. So how to use that RAF? I'm just going to utilize that. So now, so I just added this. Now is true. If it gets the true from here, then it will show this true. Otherwise, else it will show the things which we defined here. Now in our case, our iteration is the body for this. If it is true, okay, and this account records also will be there. Okay, and then here I want to show a message. Please click on click me button to view records. Done. Now here I don't have truthy. First of all, I have to make this dynamic by using this. If account records dot length greater than 0, then only it should show. That's it. Now let's see the output. See, please click on click me button to view records. Now let's see that. You can see, and it hides your message. So let's put break here just to have this button handle the result. With this, we got to know how to use RAF also. Now we have to know how to use the external JavaScript libraries and CSS libraries. Okay, for that, what we have to do, see here, have, for now, what we are going to do is we are going to download, to download Bootstrap. Okay. So in our example, we are going to apply this Bootstrap styles. And if you observe here, I am not using extends force colon SLDS, and I am not applying SLDS styles also then, because I want to apply my own styles from the libraries, or otherwise I want to write my own methods if I need. Okay, this is the way I want to do. Okay, let's see how we can do that. First thing is, you have to download Bootstrap. Okay, through this download Bootstrap button, you can have Bootstrap styles, everything. Okay, and then you can have jQuery 2.2 dot whatever. By using this also, jQuery min.js, you can get that from jQuery also. Okay, and then you have to upload these things into the static resources. Where you can find out static resources? Here. So in the static resources, you have to upload and then give names here, whatever you want. Okay. And now in this file, you can have like this. You can have files like this, and you can include in the Lightning component to utilize these things. How we can include? By using Lightning require, how we can include, we are going to see that. It's just very, very easy. So let's go to Lightning require. And if you see here, where is that? Instead of that, let's go with this. This is the one. And if you see here, you can include these things. Okay. Now, let's go with our small method and everything. Let me show you that. I have created a method. So you can see in the static resources, it's my own method, my JavaScript, and you can see that's JavaScript file. Nothing will be there. See, here I have call me method. Okay, whatever the message you pass, then it will give that message along with you called me boy. Okay, so let's see everything here now. So we have one example, we can take that from. And let me explain you. Shit. How to include? First thing is, this Lightning require, it won't support the CDN. CDN means, so you can include that URL itself, and you can it can use that styles. Okay, but now here, what it supports, you always need to download the JavaScript libraries or CSS libraries and put it in the static resource, and you can include by using styles attribute of require if it is CSS file. Otherwise, you have to include scripts by using scripts. And if you have init methods, whenever you are using this kind of Lightning JavaScript, I mean external JavaScript libraries or otherwise external CSS, you have to use this attribute to call the method which is going to be invoked when component loads. Okay, when component loads, to invoke one method, we have one handler, that is init handler. But whenever you have this kind of loading external JavaScript libraries, external CSS libraries, then you have to use this one. Okay, then your method will be invoked with the complete loading of JavaScript libraries. Otherwise, you may have different outputs. You can't use the JavaScript libraries. Sometimes it may not be loaded, it may be loaded. Instead of that, if you invoke that method, which is not be invoked from the, which is going to be invoked when the component loads, you have to invoke that method by using this after scripts loaded. Then this method will be loaded after loading of all CSS and the styles libraries into your component. Then your output will be the expected output. Instead of init method, you have to use this after scripts loaded. And then whenever you have multiple scripts, multiple script files need to be in, included, you have to use join. By using this, you can do. Now, let's go with so see here. So for now, we don't need to use this after scripts loaded also, because we are getting the result when we click on button, but not on components initiation, okay, or component load. So now I am going to include these things. See, this is my JavaScript, this is my file, okay, and this is jQuery reference, okay, and from that I defined this. If you have only one file, you don't need to add these paths, you just need to use only JavaScript or resource name only. Just now this bootstrap is the zip file which contains different kind of files, then you have to give this path like this along with the resource name, static resource name. See here, I need min.js file, I need min.css file, then I can include now, okay. And let's go to bootstrap w3 schools. I'll show you how we can apply. If you don't know, you can have that. See this one. So if you see here, you have different kinds of tables. If I open this, try it yourself. See, you have different kind of things, table bordered, table stripped. Okay, if we go with this table bordered, how it looks like. So if I put here, let me open directly. Why we have to see, this is the table and table bordered class, then automatically it looks like this. Now I'm going to apply these kind of things on our component, and now we already downloaded everything whatever it needs, okay. This is called as CDN, but our lightning required won't support this. You have to download that files and include in the static resource. And now let's apply. First thing is, if you observe, I am going to copy paste that thing else. See here, I'm going to do copy paste. Now, okay, table border, and here I'm going to close table. So I'm taking the same example instead of confusing you, okay. If you see, I'm building step by step, step by step, then you can understand easily what is going on. Now, what else we have in this? We have table header. So in our case, nothing. I'm just doing copy paste here. Done. Now, what else we have? T body. Where we need to have this? Okay, and then, so rows will be generated from here, right? So you have to do rows. So here, these are all dynamic rows. So you have to put like this. Done. Let's see how it looks like now. And now I already gave table border. Demo 6. See, please click on click me button to view records. If you observe, already changed. So, and one more thing, while you are using Bootstrap, you always need to use this thing also. Use this metadata viewport, then you will have all the things involved, and when you are working with the responsive everything, it will adjust everything. Okay, let's put that here. Okay, I already given. Okay, now you have that. See how it looks like? Now it's applied Bootstrap styles. Now I want to apply the same thing for ClickMe also. So in Bootstrap, you have different types of brands. So see here, primary. I want to apply primary. How can I apply? Just this class, nothing else. See, just see this classes and give this. I'm not doing any rocket science. I'm just doing copy and paste. But only the thing is, I should know that this message class was already there. Okay, class is already there. Okay, it's not our component. This is our component. Okay, now I am giving this class here. I'm just doing copy paste, but I know how to include JavaScript libraries from external side, external libraries. What I have to do, I have to download those things, and I have to put in static resources, and to include that in your component, you just need to use the lightning required. See here, see, click me. It is having brand new styles. Done. Let me remove all these alerts. Then you can have the things. Where we have that component method caller, and I'm removing these alerts. Done. See, it looks like this. And if you apply something else also, so here you have tables, right? Good tables. Now I want table strip. You can apply. It gives output, right? Table strip means gray and white. You can see this output here itself. Same output you are getting. See, table strip. This is how we can apply external style sheets and external libraries into Lightning component by using Lightning required. Any doubts up to this? Yes. Cool. Thank you. All the best.